Hello students, welcome you all. So today we are going to study and understand the first chapter of your course book, A Hero. A Hero is written by R.K. Narayana. Now we are going to look at few topics on this chapter. The first topic is the source. So source means from where the story is taken. So there are many novels written by R.K. Narayana. Under those, one of the novel is Under the Banyan Tree and Other Stories. So this is the source of this story, Under the Banyan Tree and Other Stories. So it is taken from there. Now look at the theme. Theme means obviously what message or what role does this text or the story has to play. In A Hero, we see that we have the theme of fear, insecurity, control, powerlessness, bravery and independence. So later on we will see more about all these things, of all these adjectives which are used here in theme, like fear, insecurity, control, power, lessness and bravery and independence. Let's look at the next one, title. Title is A Hero. Okay, so who is a hero? If you talk about hero, then the things which come in our mind, that hero is someone who gives of himself, often putting his own life at great risk. No, so a hero saves us from the danger. He risks his own life, or she risks her own life, and he or she does it for the good of others. Heroes overcome their fear of danger in order to do good for others. No, so hero means someone who does good to others. Hero means someone who saves others. Hero means someone who helps others. Now, if like we think about it, like who is a hero, then obviously our soldiers, our hero, the first thing which come in our mind, that our soldiers who save us from danger, who protect our country, so they are our hero. And there could be many more heroes. There could be so many heroes to name. So we are not going into all that. We are going into the next topic now. R.K. Narayana. Let's look at the writer R.K. Narayana's life. So he was born in 1906. Okay, 1906. And his father was a headmaster. So he's some schooling done at that school. Worked as a reporter at Madras. So he was awarded by A.C. Benson Medal. Also awarded by Padma Vibhushan. And died in 2001. So this is the brief life of R.K. Narayana. R.K. Narayana's novels. As I was talking about the novels, Swami and Friends. This is a famous novel. The Bachelors of Arts, The English Teacher, The Guide, The Man Eater of Malgudi, The Vendors of Sweets. Okay, so all these are the novels of R.K. Narayana. R.K. Narayana, his full name is Rasipuram Krishnaswami Iyer Narayanaswami. Then he is among the most famous Indian novelists, and he began his writing with Swami and Friends, the first novel which you see in the list of the novels. Let's look at the next topic. The next topic is the storyline. So when you start reading the story, you will feel that it is a very funny and very enjoyable story. Like there are many comic scenes over here. The dialogues are also there which are very funny. The incidents which happen over here in this story are also funny. But there are also irony implied in that. Means the writer was not only creating the comical scenes, but also he was trying to give some message through those scenes. Like he was creating those scenes to highlight the irony of the situations, and he was trying to put some message through those things. First, if you look at the opening of the story, where we see that Swami's father was reading a newspaper. Now, we all know that Swami's father was strict, no? And his father was a strict father who used to give lessons to his son through various ways. And here, when his father was reading the newspaper, he was reading it aloud. Swami was listening to the news. Now, the father read in the newspaper one article, okay? And when the father read that article described that in that article of the newspaper, there was a story of a boy who was returning from the jungle and he fell in face of a tiger, like a village boy, okay? A village boy was described in the newspaper article, came face to face with a tiger. But the village boy showed a great amount of courage and faced the tiger. After that, the villagers came and they rescued the boy. So the father was very glad to hear this story of this village boy, and he read that story to Swami. Now, the father was expecting that Swami will also be like this village boy, no? But Swami is not believing this story of the father. Now, what happens? Swami had the habit of sleeping with his grandmother after listening to a story told by her. So Swami used to sleep with grandmother. He was sleeping with grandmother, and he used to listen to story from grandmother. Now the father, father of Swami, he thought that why not Swami sleep alone? So what did he do? Swami is challenged by his father to prove his courage by sleeping alone in the office room. So we see that Swami's father is challenging Swami. Swami's father is telling to Swami that why don't you sleep alone? So his father gave the task to him that you go and sleep alone in the office room. Now Swami is terrified. Swami is afraid, okay? And tries various methods to get out of it. Swami employs many tactics like appealing to his mother and grandmother, but no avail. So Swami was trying that he will not go to the office room, and maybe his father will forgive him and he will let him sleep with his grandmother. But the father was strict and he took him to the office room. There we see that Swami even told the room is dusty and there could be a scorpions behind the law books. See, Swami slept in the office room. But Swami's father won't let him leave a lamp, have a lamp, but allows him to keep the door open and suggests he sleeps on the bench. Swami is sleeping on the bench, and if he is worried about the scorpions, so Swami used another tactics that there are scorpions in the office room, but father told no, you can sleep in the bench. After lying awake for ages, imagining the host and the frightened of the shadows and the night noises, he moves to a more secure place under the bench. So Swami was like imagining all sorts of ghosts and tiger in his dreams, and he was so afraid that he could not sleep there properly. Okay. When he awakes from his nightmare, all these were nightmares actually. When he awake of his nightmare, he feels terrified and is horrified to sense something moving in the room. And he saw something moving. Then, in fear for his life, he attacks the devil by biting it. The devil turns out to be a burglar. So it was a thief which came to Swami's place. It was a thief which entered into Swami's room. And when Swami felt that there is something moving, he bit that. Because Swami was afraid and he thought that something has come to chase me or catch me. It can be something, a ghost, a nightmare which he actually had. And that's why he bit the thief. Later on, all people like Swami's father, cook and the servant came and they catch the thief. And the thief had a bleeding ankle because of the boy who bite him because of Swami. And Swami didn't do it because he was a courageous boy. Swami did it because he thought to save himself only from the danger. So Swami is seen to be a hero for catching the thief. And everyone thought that Swami has caught this thief. Okay, and they thought that Swami is a very courageous boy. Even the police appreciate him and want him to join the police force. Even the police called him and told that you can join our force. Okay, but Swami wants to work as an engine driver or a bus conductor. The next night he goes to bed in his old place next to grandma before his father returns home. So Swami again, he was back to his grandmother's place where he was sleeping usually, and he didn't sleep in the office. So through this story or through this comical situations, we learned that Swami's courage was actually a false courage because he didn't show it out of his brave nature. He showed it out of his coward nature, where he was so much afraid of the ghost and so much afraid of the tiger chasing him that he goes on to the thief and he bite him. Okay, so I hope you all understand this, and later on we will discuss more things on this text. Thank you all.